arising out of the implementation of the devolution plan. Now, what is the immediate consequence of the 18th amendment? That is the interesting part. Two things happened simultaneously in the area of labor. एक तरफ तो फेडरल गवर्नमेंट का लॉ मेकिंग पावर खत्म हो गया और दूसरी चीज IRO अपने लाइफ खो बैठा. IRO 2008 अपने लाइफ खो बैठा. बाकी लॉज के बारे में तो यह है कि दे आर ऑल इन ऑपरेशन टिल द डिवोल्यूशन डज नॉट टेक इट्स नॉर्मल completes this normal circle. So, all other labor laws which are federal continue to apply to provinces, and the provinces will either have to adopt all those laws through the parliament, through the provincial assemblies, or can delete the laws which they do not want to carry on with, or amend them in the way they like most. But for doing this, they have time. Those laws do not immediately cease to exist. But in the case of IRO, thing was different. In the case of IRO, different interpretations started coming in. Because there was no IRO, every high court started giving different interpretations. And finally, the Supreme Court gave its judgment. In the constitutional petition, in the case reported in 2011 SCMR page 1254, Air League of PIAC Employees Union versus Federation of Pakistan, the full bench of the Supreme Court announced that the 18th constitutional amendment has abolished the concurrent legislative list and the federal government has lost the power to legislate regarding labor welfare except recourse to the provisions of article 144(1) of the constitution. This laid to rest all the guesses, all the interpretations which were being given to the existence or non-existence in any form of IRO 2008. And once for all it was decided that IRO 2008 is dead. To substitute the vacuum, therefore, all the four provinces already adopted, if the child ko adopt kar raha na, already adopted the IRO 2008 with some modification here and there, Punjab, Sindh, Frontier and Balochistan, through the acts of their provincial assemblies have already introduced an IRO, IR Act. And they have taken mostly the provisions of IRO 69 with some amendments made in IRO 2002. But new issues arose in the area of industrial relations. Baki law mein to ek alag challenge hai, usko bhi discuss karte hain. But what happened in IRO issue? Even when the provinces made legislation, there were three areas which did not find a response. Three areas where the vacuum remained. Number one, how would the industrial relations of an establishment be managed which exists in more than one provinces? And most of them were government itself. Like WABDA, like PIA, large organizations and many private establishments. So first, how do they manage their industrial relations in case where they have establishments spread over in different provinces, one major area. Second major area, how would the welfare acts, particularly Social Security and UBI, which were federally administered and implemented, would be managed. Third, what will happen to the international labor standards? Who will ratify and de-ratify the ILO conventions and meet the international obligations to which Pakistan was now more being at the point of being caught, particularly when it comes to legislation or incorporating those standards in the national legislation. Another, a fourth auxiliary issue is also emerging out of this scenario. Interestingly, that how would the National Workers Federation and National Employers Federation be managed? So, I see these four very important areas emerging out of the industrial relations scenario. That is one. The second one is other labor laws. What is to be done? Now, somebody asked me a very interesting question. What is the status of the sixth labor policy? Now, labor policy is an indication of the mind of what the government wants to do, or the party in power wants to do, and party in power is in all the four provinces. So, they have spoken up their mind. And what have they spoken up in the sixth labor policy? Again, three very important things. How much they implement is to be seen. Number one, simplification of labor laws. Voluminous. Simplification of labor laws into six major laws. A lot of work had already started for the last 3 to 4 years. A lot of draft had almost been completed, particularly in the area of Employment Service Conditions Act and contract labor and health and safety and compensation. That is one. Number two, it says the rights and duties of employers and workers will be protected. This is another story, that when IRO 2008 was implemented, the code of conduct of 2002 was omitted. That code of conduct which defined the rights and duties of employers and workers, and which had become with great difficulty part of the IRO, was omitted. And now the sixth labor policy says that we will ensure the security of the rights and duties of employers, both. How they are going to do it is yet to be seen. And the third main point of the sixth labor policy was that they will have a policy of human resource development in the country. So far, none of the labor policy focused on this area. So, at least these three very important points of the sixth labor policy do concern us. Lekin ab ek aur himakat jo inhone kiya, या सरजद हुआ, वो ये था कि you know.